for tuning in. My name is Catherine Gaho, and I'm an entrepreneur. If you are new here, remember to hit that subscriber button.
How to test your business attractiveness. Testing business or brand attractiveness is important for any type or size of business. It helps you know where you stand and what marketing efforts you need to make to keep driving your business forward and to great success. This business or brand attractiveness test is a measure of the business appeal from the customer's point of view. It is beneficial to the business because it enhances profitability. A business with high attractiveness can charge a premium price and still get great reviews from customers. This attractiveness test is relevant to any type of business, and it works for small, medium, and large enterprises. It applies to you even if you own a business that serves in your local community. It's a principle that cuts across, a principle that applies to many types of situations. It applies if your business is a restaurant, a nightclub, a gym, a car wash, car sales, real estate agency, insurance agency, salon, barbershop, or clothing boutique. It works even if you are in professional services, such as consultancy, legal firm, medical practice, dentist, or even an accountant. You could also be in the arts and it will still serve you. You could be a music teacher, a dance instructor, a recording studio, photographer, graphic designer, or even an event organizer. So this is a test that helps the business understand itself, how appealing it is from the point of view of the customer. How attractive is your business from the customer point of view? Let's go straight to the questions that you need to ask in order to understand your business or brand attractiveness.
One, how many customers are willing to recommend your brand to others? The customers who are willing to tell others in their social circle about how great your brand is and to encourage others to buy it are called brand promoters or brand evangelists. Brand promoters will recommend your brand, but when they move to the level of an evangelist, they will preach about your brand. They will go telling everybody who cares to listen about your brand. Only a small number of people will serve as your brand promoters or brand evangelists. They are willing to share or forward your messages, your flyers, your brochures, even discuss your advertisements and push others to buy from you. You know, the kind of person who comes and grabs you and tells you, let's go, I show you something great I found. You should buy this one. No, you should buy this one. There are people who are like that. They inspire and encourage you to buy from a brand that they love. Brand evangelists are critical because they improve brand attractiveness. How many people are willing to buy from you repeatedly or to only buy your brand? This is a measure of brand loyalty. Brand loyal customers will walk from shop to shop, store to store, looking for your brand, even when there are many other substitutes that could solve the problem. They are not willing to make the shift. These are people who are loyal to your brand and are not willing to compromise. They believe in your brand. They have confidence in your brand's ability to consistently deliver on its promise, and its promise matches their expectations. Brand loyal customers improve your brand attraction and brand value. How much do customers trust your brand? This is a measure of brand credibility. Customers who trust your brand today will be your loyal customers tomorrow and your brand evangelists next week. So you must work to build trust by keeping your promises, being consistent, and providing superior customer experience. These days, many people trust what they hear from their friends, family, followers on Twitter, Facebook fans, Instagram, and the like, much more than they trust your own brand communication. So it's important for you to ensure that you're trustworthy across the board so that these customers can be able to confirm from their friends and their social circles about your credibility. Trust is critical because it improves your brand value and your brand attractiveness. What do customers think about your brand's quality? This is a measure of perceived quality. That is what customers think or perceive your overall quality to be. That is your product quality, service quality, quality of engagement, quality of interactions, your ability to deliver, consistency, and all those things that people perceive around a product that make them conclude that you really are a quality brand. Perceived quality is important because it improves brand value and also improves attractiveness. What do customers know about your brand? That speaks to brand awareness. This element focuses on what people know about a brand, how to identify it, where it can be found, how much it costs, its distinguishing characteristics, you know, the product or service attributes, values and features, what problem it solves for the customer, the value it adds, what it does and who it's for, what are the brand differentiators and the like. These are things customers need to be aware of. They need to know about this. And if they know more about your brand and can answer many of these questions, then we say that you have high brand awareness. A brand with high awareness is more likely to be selected than a brand with low brand awareness. Awareness encourages purchase and improves attractiveness. Thank you for watching this video. Remember to subscribe and like it so that we can bring you more like it. Let me ask you a question. What action will you take in the next few days to improve on your brand value and attractiveness? Thank you and best wishes. We all need to elevate our mindset at this time.